Yeah, the music's very low.
Yeah, well,
I don't hear music.
The music. Yeah, the music's in the background. But if you can't hear that, you might have a problem hearing it. But we'll try it when the show starts. All right. It's 7 o'clock. Everybody's here, right? Yeah. All right. Let's go ahead and start. Let's see if we can start this.
Okay.
All right. So we're live. Everybody can see us now. Hey, gang. Hi, Twitchers.
Oh, no.
Watching us. Thanks for tuning in. This is all your favorite game shows. I'm your host, Paul Goebel. What we've done is we've taken all your favorite game shows and we've jammed them all together, and we're going to play them tonight with the help of some of your favorite comedians and funny people. They are all here and ready to go. But of course, I never do this on my own. I couldn't. How could I? It's impossible. It's too much work for one man, which is why I always have my co-host, Mr. Steve Mandel. Give him a round of applause.
Hello.
Everybody. Steve Mandel. There it is. There's your applause. Ooh. And there's a boo for you, too. Steve, what is new? You're looking good. You're down to two chins. Congratulations.
All my other chins have just kind of melted inside my neck, which is kind of disturbing.
I am very impressed. You're doubly vaxxed, just like me.
I am, 2 weeks as of yesterday, so I'm ready to start licking shit.
So, and you're excited to go out and see the movies, right?
I am going to go see a movie and a live band this weekend. Damn. I don't care which ones.
What if it was Nickelback and Nickelback the movie? Would you still go?
If I could get free tickets.
Hmm. All right, I like you're committed to it. Remember a few weeks ago I was talking about how sometimes... when you're a big fan, you watch a show and it's clear they made a joke just for you and you feel very seen by the creators, you know? We were talking about that the other day. Well, are you watching this show, City on a Hill? This cop drama, it's on Showtime and Hulu, Kevin Bacon.
I do not have Showtime.
Okay, well, it's also on Hulu, but it's a really serious cop drama set in Boston in like the late 80s, I think. And there's a lot of blood and a lot of cussing in it. But because it's set in Boston, they had to do a shout out to St. Elsewhere fans. And in the second season, this woman gets dropped off at St. Allegis Hospital. And as they go by the emergency room entrance, it says the Bruce Paltrow Emergency Wing. Of course, Bruce Paltrow, Gwyneth Paltrow's dad, who created St. Elsewhere and The White Shadow. And it was really quick. I had to rewind it to see it. But I thought, man, that's so cool, because that means that universe is getting even bigger and bigger. You know what I mean?
No, it's not, because that universe is just a dream in an autistic kid's mind. So.
Yeah, some people have argued that it is at all, but that's not how autism works. I'm no doctor, but I know that's not how autism works. So, but on the other hand, there's this other show called Cruel Summer, which is on Freeform and Hulu, and it's really good. Hey, there's Matt's cat. And it's really good. It's a teenager show, but I really like it. And yet, Harley Quinn Smith is a supporting character on the show. Of course, that's Kevin Smith's daughter, who I met when she was a baby, oddly enough. At one point in this last episode, she's talking to her friend. She's like, come on, let's go home and watch Clerks for the 20th time. And you know, I'm all for a nod to fans, but let's not rewrite history, okay? Let's not convince people that Clerks is good enough to watch 20 times. That's a little much.
Whoa. That's my favorite. Come on.
Wait, that's your favorite movie or your favorite Kevin Smith movie?
That's my favorite movie.
All right. Well, I'm sorry you have to go, Shelby, but thank you for joining us. No, I mean, honestly,
it's her dad's movie, Carly's, not Shelby's, so you have to imagine that she's seen it 20 times, whether or not she wanted to.
But there, even in his catalog, there are better movies to watch than Clerks. I understand it was the first one he did, and I'll give him props.
Oh.
But come on.
Red State was amazing.
There you go, Red State. Watch that. That's a sleeper.
Can you send away for that catalog?
That's a deep cut. Yes. Unfortunately, they sign you up for a lot of other catalogs after that. You get signed up for like Dax Shepard director catalog. Not good.
Yes.
Little fun movie trivia, by the way, guys.
Matt.
The movie Clerks was made for a low budget.
That's the trivia?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
But it made quite a lot of money eventually. It's just, I'm a bit of a film nerd, so I know this.
Yeah, interesting. Well, feel free to drop in with all that trivia throughout the show. That's what people tune in to see.
You would never be able to tell that was a low-budget movie. It's all on the screen.
Oh,
you said you didn't know how autism worked, but I think Matt just demonstrated.
Well done. All right. Well, Steve, do you have anything to say before we start this show?
No, I can't top that.
Okay. In that case, let's go ahead and play The Price is Right. Who's on
Matt
the show?
Matt Kirshen, come on down. Ron Lynch, come on down.
What?
J.P. Manu, wow. Come on down. Whoa. Eddie Petoskey, come on down. And Shelby Gonzalez, come on down.
All right. You guys all got picked to play The Price is Right. Congratulations. You know how The Price is Right works. Just like on television, I have a bunch of items here. I will hold them up and Steve will describe them. You have to guess how much these items are worth without going over. Whoever is the closest without going over will get a point. The only difference between these items and the items on The Price is Right is that all these are $5 or less. All right? None of these items cost more than $5. So do not overbid. I guarantee you someone's going to overbid on something, but I'm trying to warn you.
So if we say $6, right. Well, we're an idiot.
Because I was being attacked by a cat.
Yes, if you say $6, you're an idiot. You know how to play this game, Matt. You've done this before. Quit trying to act like you're new. All right? Steve, what is the first item up for bids?
This first item up for bids is a 2.5 ounce bag of cauliflower chips, cauliflower crisps from Hippie Snacks, made from cauliflower, seeds, and dill weed. These classic ranch-flavored snacks will be sure to disappoint even the wokest of kids.
Ah, it's cauliflower snacks. You can't quite see the bag because of my green screen. But yeah, cauliflower crisps that taste like ranch. I have not tried them, and I do not plan to. So Shelby, you get to bid first. What do you think I paid for these bad boys?
$3.
$3 even from Shelby Gonzalez. JP Manu, your bid.
Paul, those chips are $1.89.
$1.89 from Mr. Manu. Shady Petoskey, what do you think?
I'm going to go with 301.
301. Nice. Very shrewd. Ron Lynch, what do you say?
$1.49.
$1.49 for Mr. Lynch. And Matt Kirshen, you bid last. What do you say?
All right. Well, I think it's between the $1 people and the $3 people. So I'm going $1.90.
1.90. Wow. From Matt Kirshen, and that's in dollars, not pounds.
Sorry, JP.
Steve!
Unless I'm exactly right!
Who's taking it home?
Matt's experience in this game pays off. The actual retail price was $2.50. Matt is our winner.
Well done, Matt. Yeah. You got yourself a point and scored those chips. Good job.
That's what a ripoff.
It's just, right? Too much. All right, what's next, Steve?
This next item is a 12-ounce can of Dr. Dynamite soda. The only soda endorsed by Jimmy J.J. Walker. It's not just good, it's dynamite.
There you go. Delicious Dr. Dynamite. So Matt got, so Shelby, you get to bid first on this. What do you think I paid for this Dr. Dynamite?
I mean, I'd say the soda by itself is probably $80, but I think you're paying like a good $15 dynamite premium on there. So I'm saying
$95.
Sorry, 95 cents.
Oh, 95 cents.
Sorry.
Wow.
Oh, you guys don't spend $90 on a soda?
It depends.
But on Dr. Dynamite, we don't.
Some of the good stuff. All right, so Matt says 90 cents. Shelby, what do you think?
You guys weren't distracted by the fact that you're now bleeding because your cat attacked you in the middle of the first round?
Shelby, your bid?
Say $1.50.
Oh, $1.50 from Shelby Gonzalez. Nice. JP Manu, what do you say?
Do we have any other information? Did you get this on eBay?
No, I bought it at the Safeway down the street from me. It's a Signature Select brand soda. That's pretty much all you need to know.
79 cents.
79 cents from JP. Shady, what's your bid?
I don't know. You clearly live in a food desert, so I have to... get back to the, I think, 50 cents.
50 cents. That is accurate. I live in the desert. It's Arizona. Ron Lynch, what do you think?
29 cents.
29 cents from Ron Lynch, going down low. All right, Steve, I think someone got it. Who is it?
The actual retail price is 35 cents. Ron is our winner.
There you go, Ron Lynch. Excellent. Oh, yeah. Wow. He knows his.
Why aren't we all drinking that? Why aren't we bathing in it?
I don't know,
it's
man.
It's a crappy brand.
It's not good for your skin, I'll be honest. Ron knows his cheap-ass sodas. All right, Steve, what's up next?
If you're like me, Steve Mandel, the person who definitely wrote this item description, you just can't get enough of Baby Shark. That's why this box of Baby Shark fruit snacks from Nickelodeon is the only gluten-free snack for me, Steve Mandel, the guy that wrote this item description.
All right, Steve, we get it. You love Baby Shark. My God. All right, enough. So Ron got that one. So Matt, you can bid first this time. What do you think I paid for these fruit snacks?
I'm going to say $2.04.
$2.04 from Matt Kirshen. Shelby, your bid?
I'll say $2.
$2 even. Nice. JP, what do you think?
Back at you, Matt. $2.05.
Brutal.
Oh, it is on.
It's on now. Shady, what do you say?
I'm going to go with $1.04.
104 FM on your FM dial. And Ron Lynch, you bid last. What do you think?
207.
207 from Ron, the asshole Lynch. All right, Steve, who gets these snacks?
The actual retail price is $1.50. Shady is our winner.
All right. Good job. Shady got a point. She's on the board. All right, we got a couple left here. This one's definitely, I know, of value to someone here. Steve, tell them all about it.
This I'm going to have to disqualify myself. No, I'm kidding.
Because you know exactly what
this next item is a plush Rosie O'Donnell doll that someone got rid of long after they should have. It also says a bunch of stupid shit that she herself would make fun of.
So let's see if you can hear what she says.
Dreams come true with Rosie.
Did you hear that? And then she goes like that. Yeah, it's pretty fucking bad. All right. Yeah, her voice box gets stuck.
So what is worth what it sells for?
So pay for it. Wait, who got it? Ron? So Matt, you bid first again. What do you think?
Bidding first always. Wow. All right.
Oh, wait, who got those fruit snacks?
I didn't get it.
Oh, that was Shady.
That was Shady.
Oh, okay, so Ron, you get to bid first on this Rosie O'Donnell.
There's no way that's less than $5.
Ron, yes, it is. I got it at Goodwill.
Oh, wow. Okay.
It's yeah, huge. Goodwill, I'm going to say $3.50.
$3.50 from Ron Lynch. Matt, your bid? Look at her nose.
What did Shady say? I missed the
bid. No, Shady didn't bid yet. Ron said $3.
$3.50.
$3.50 from Ron.
I'm gonna say $4.01.
$4.01 for Matt. Okay,
this is a premium item.
Shelby, what do you think?
$3.50.
Ron said
$3.50 has already been said.
Ron said $3.50.
Motherfuck. Okay. $4.
I think $4 has already been said.
Matt said $4. You can literally say any other number. You can say any other number. What is it?
401.
No one's taken. I'm done.
All right. 401 from Shelby Gonzalez. JP, what do you think?
$4.17 exactly.
417 from JP. And Shady, you bid last. What do you say?
I got to be shrewd and go with the one cent.
She's going to go down low. I like it. Nice and shrewd. Steve, who gets Rosie?
The actual retail price is $3.49. Shady's bet paid off.
On fire. Nice.
I had my one thing.
Steve wanted to.
Oh, my gosh.
Ron wanted to go up top.
One penny.
Went too high. Flew too close to the sun, Ron. All right. Last item up for bid. Steve, tell them all about it.
Did your uncle murder your dad and is now trying to murder you? Well, then, you'll be right at home with this Simba toque hat thing. Oh, and if you're worried about looking stupid, Hakuna Matata.
All right. I don't know if this is Simba or some other character from The Lion King, but yeah, you get the idea. Ron, you get to bid first. What do you think I paid for this?
Can I know what it's made of?
It feels like cotton. Let's see. The tag says all new material, polyester fibers, polyurethane foam, made in China. Oh, made for disguise. So it's so that's what that's
God, where did Paul go?
In that case, I'm gonna say $275.
All right, $275 from Ron Lynch. Matt, you bid next.
Okay, I'm kind of freaking the fuck out here because I've never actually been spoken to by a real lion before. But I would say I'm going 1 cent on this one.
He goes down low to 1 cent. All right, let's see if that pays off. Shelby, what do you think?
And by the way, I don't think that's not me bidding low. That's me thinking it's actually worth 1 cent.
Yeah, I get it. I get it. Shelby?
$375
from Shelby G. JP, what do you say?
I can't imagine this thing's worth $4, but I'm going to say $4.
He can't imagine it, and yet he forced himself to imagine it. Shady, you're last.
How did they spell Disney on it?
Oh, no, I can't.
Very good.
Is it even? I don't know if the word Disney appears on it.
All right, then I'm gonna go with two cents then. Sorry.
Ah, 2 cents.
I'm still gonna win it when I'm dead on.
2 cents. That's true. That's only one way Matt can win. All right, all the bids are in. Steve, who got the last one?
The actual retail price is $249. Shady is our winner.
Damn, yay! She's on fire.
Wow. Yes.
All right.
Playing ruthless. Playing brutal.
Ruthless. She could not be with us tonight. All right. Some people scored some points in that round. Let's go ahead and pump the brakes a little bit, Steve. What do you say? You want to meet?
Sure.
You want to meet our contestants?
I can meet a couple of them.
Okay, who's up first?
According to Wikipedia, Matt Kirshen is a British comedian, actor, writer, and presenter based in Los Angeles.
That's right off your Wikipedia page, Matt.
That is true, yes.
Matt?
I'm technically all of those four things and that location.
So that works out. It's nice. It's nice that Wikipedia is so up to date. How often do you update it?
I've recently been leaving it alone because a good friend of mine's been sabotaging it, and I want to see how long it'll stay there.
Nice. It's funny when you see your own Wikipedia page. It's an odd thing, isn't it? Because you're like, well, I see some things here that are missing, but should I bother? Like, I sent him a picture to put on mine, but that's pretty much all I wanted to do with it. It's
which part of that description was the sabotage? The British part?
The bit that says I was in a double act at college called Crazy and the Wilf.
Now, are you still friends with the Wilf?
Oh yeah. We get on handsomely.
Now, Matt, you've played the game before. You played back when we had the long version, but you didn't win last time. Now, do you have a strategy coming into this game to win to score more points this time?
Yeah, I'm going for the sympathy angle this time, and may I reiterate the fact that I am still bleeding.
Right, you're bleeding because your cat attacked you.
He had feline COVID.
Yeah.
Are you vaccinated?
I'm vaccinated against COVID, but not rabies, so we'll see how it goes.
All right, or cat scratch fever.
Same thing.
Ted Nugent might come over. Well, if people want to see, I assume now that the world's opening up, you're going to go back out, start doing stand-up, tell some jokes?
Yeah, that's the plan. I'm going to be out in Colorado at the end of June, which will be my first time getting on a plane and telling jokes indoors since everything.
Yeah. Oh, that'll be fun. All right. And if people
see how that feels.
If people want to know more about that, where can they go to find out information?
Oh, well, I'll be tweeting all of that stuff out when it gets nearer the time. And also, if you live anywhere in sort of Colorado, I'm going to be at the new Fort Collins Comedy Fort Comedy Club and then the Boulder Comedy Club.
There you go.
The last weekend of June.
And you probably wouldn't be doing.
Yeah, those are great. You're both great.
You probably wouldn't be doing any drugs while you're there the whole time, right? You probably won't be doing that at all.
I won't be doing drugs. No, it's far too high an altitude, and I'm far too high not a citizen.
Oh, that's right. I forgot. You're not from here. All right. Well, thank you for joining us, Matt. I appreciate you coming back. Thank you very much.
Thanks for having me, Paul.
Steve, who else is on the show tonight?
Ron Lynch has been performing comedy for over four decades and is considered one of the forefathers of alternative comedy. His credits include Corporate, Portlandia, Another Period, The Sarah Silverman Program, he played all the doctors, Conan, Andy Richter Controls the Universe, and several sitcom appearances. Presently, he is the host slash producer of the popular Tomorrow variety show in Hollywood.
It's so popular.
Now in its 16th year.
16th year. Now, so you've been doing comedy for 40 years. You've been doing this show for almost half that time. And yet, you're still a young, good-looking, virile man. How do you explain that, Ron?
And I'm doing this show. So, I mean, that says a lot.
Oh, my internet connection's unstable for kids at home. Yeah.
No, that's a good thing. I figured out the thing, by the way. Yeah.
I love the Tomorrow Show. That was one of my favorite shows to do back in the day when I lived there, when you used to do it at the Steve Allen.
The Steve Allen. Yeah, that was great.
That place is still there, yes?
It is a lot.
Really? The building's no longer there? Because I know that's where they shot that show Barry there. That's where Henry Winkler's class was.
Right, that was the last thing that it was used for.
Wow.
It was supposed to be condos. First of all, they didn't get the right to knock it down for like 8 months. They finally knocked it down, and then they don't have the right to build condos. So now they have to sell it.
Just a lot. That seems to be a thing in LA.
For no reason.
There was a building in LA when they tore down the old spaghetti factory on Sunset or Hollywood.
Right.
And they said, well, we're going to tear it down. And they said, well, if you do, you have to build another spaghetti factory in the bottom of the building. And they were like, well, absolutely do that. And then they didn't. They built the building without it. And eventually the people came back and said, hey, you have to tear this down because you didn't put the spaghetti factory in it. And everybody had to move out.
Oh, my God.
Wasn't it called the Old Spaghetti Factory?
Yeah, the Old Spaghetti Factory. Yeah.
Wonderful opportunity for branding for the new Spaghetti Factory.
Right? And it's like, I mean, that's the new thing, right? To put stores and restaurants in the bottom of your building. Isn't that the cool, hip thing to do now? Why wouldn't you want an Old Spaghetti Factory in the bottom of your building? That'd be fucking great, man.
And you always forget, like, this city's absolute reliance on spaghetti. Like, if there aren't sufficient spaghetti,
absolutely. LA, I don't know how many times the city shut down when there was a lack of spaghetti in LA. I was like, God damn it.
Yeah,
I'm stuck on the 405. Where's my
spaghetti? There's never enough water.
Don't you guys just steal all of your spaghetti from Colorado?
Yeah, that's true.
Ron, where do you do the Tomorrow Show now?
From the hills.
I know you were doing it Dynasty Typewriter for
now.
A while.
And then at the Lyric Hyperion, which hasn't reopened yet, but we're waiting for that. But right now we're doing it on Instagram Live every Saturday at 11.
I just saw you had a power-packed lineup this weekend. That was very impressive. So people can watch that.
It was pretty great. It was a pretty good show.
Yeah.
And this weekend coming up, depending on when this airs, it's all magic this Saturday.
Oh, magic show. Nice. Last week was 5 Minutes or Die, right? You were on the show, right, Matt?
I was on the show.
Yeah, I loved that.
I died, but everyone else did.
Those were the good old days, man, when you could just like call Ron and go, hey, I have this idea for a thing. Can I do the Tomorrow Show? And he'd be like, okay. Go ahead. I remember one night Craig Anton gave me $20 because he felt bad for me.
Hey, wait a minute. I gave you 22.
Yeah, but it was a phony. People can watch that on your Instagram Live now. Is that where they check that out?
Right, at Ron Lynch 1 every Saturday at 11 o'clock.
Excellent. Well, definitely check that out. Good shows. All right.
Do it.
Thank you, Ron. Thanks for being here and doing the show. I appreciate it.
Thank you.
Stick around. No, we're on.
You
know what? Craig Anton did that exact same joke. So congratulations to the two of you.
Well, he takes it from me.
Still working together all these years later. Steve, who's next on the show?
According to Wikipedia, J.P. Manu is an American actor, comedian, director, and writer, best known for his work as STAN in Aaron Stone, both Curtis the Caveman and Vice Principal Hackett in Field of the Future, and yes. Scrappy Rex in Scooby-Doo.
Oh, yes. Aww. Scrappy Rex. We all remember the great Scrappy
Not
Rex.
Not Scrappy.
No,
that guy's still had a contract.
Scrappy Rex, when he yeah. when he bulked out.
He turns
out.
Into a T-Rex monster.
Now, yeah. Craig was on the show a couple weeks ago, and you worked with him on Phil of the Future. And I told him this story. When that show was on, my kids were really little, and I told them that the guy who plays the principal is the same guy who plays the caveman, and they refused to believe it. They were like, it is not. And I'm like, I swear to God, I play poker with him. It's the same dude. Do you still?
If I meet three 20-somethings, two of them don't know. One of them does know, and the other two freak out.
Yeah, right? It's because, like, Bill Cott gets that in now. Like, a lot of kids who grew up watching Wizards of Waverly Place follow him on mm-hmm. TikTok and love him. But you must get that a lot from people who watch Phil of the Future growing up.
It lets you know exactly how old you are and how long it's been since the show was on TV. Because I keep thinking, like, how do you know me? You're like a grown adult. It's like, oh, right. No, you were 13 or 12 when that was on.
Nice. Yeah. But lately.
So it's like young baristas. Now it's like TSA guys.
But lately.
Those are my fans.
I assume you've been getting recognized for your stint in the hit movie Nobody, which is one of the best fucking movies out right now. That was amazing.
Yeah, I got to do a little bit in the Bob Odenkirk, John Wick-esque movie. And when I was filming it in Winnipeg in November of 2019, I had missed by one day seeing living legend Ron Lynch perform the two nights of comedy. The marquee was still up right around the corner from where they had me staying. And it was like Winnipeg's own, like he's returned, the conquering hero. And I was so bummed I missed it, Ron.
Oh,
I
hope man.
Wow, at the Park Theater.
Yeah.
How did that go?
It was also the last time that theater had a live show before they tore it down.
Probably. Yeah. Did you close that place down,
yeah, the
Ron?
The movie's really great.
They tear out down anywhere I perform. If I headline a club, that's the end of that club.
That's yeah. I think that's when they're like, listen, guys, we got to file for bankruptcy. Call Ron Lynch. But you were great. Wait. Nobody is fucking amazing. How much of what you shot ended up in the movie?
A little less than half.
Oh, that's pretty good.
There's a whole thing of me going into like the bowels of, you know, CIA and FBI and climbing ladders and
kinds
of stuff. And what you saw me reacting to when I'm being like blackmailed by the Russians is not at all what we shot or the story. I'm reacting to something totally different. And I'm being hired, if enough people have seen it, like I have a whole relationship with his father-in-law.
Oh, that's really?
Yeah, I'm answering a phone from his wife's father who's trying to do like recon on his son-in-law, and like they put stuff on my computer screen, re-edited it, and people are like, you're great in this movie. I'm like, I do better when I don't know what I'm doing.
Yeah. Well, I want to see all the deleted scenes then. I'm going to rent the DVD for sure.
That was, you were great in it, but the whole film, that was the first movie that I saw indoors since COVID.
Same.
A friend.
I went to the theater.
A friend of ours rented out the theater, which apparently I didn't know you could do.
I know a few people who've done that.
They're letting you do that now. And
yeah.
It's not that expensive per person. It's like
about
the same
amount. Tell them what movie. Tell them what movie you saw, Steve.
I did that for my movie. We went and saw the Zappa documentary.
He rented out a theater for the Frank Zappa documentary, for Christ's sake. Even the theater was like, really? This is really what you want? No, I saw it during the day. There was maybe two other people in the theater, so... it didn't matter, but it was amazing.
Exactly
movie.
The right movie to be the first thing back in the theater for.
For sure.
Like, yeah, it's something you want from a 90-minute action comedy.
For everyone who'd been home and paid $20 to see like Wonder Woman 1984.
Oh,
like,
for fuck's sake.
Just the worst.
How dare you bring up that movie to me?
Just 90 minutes of joy. Great.
All right.
Done. Roll credits. Perfect.
All right. That's a perfect place to stop talking to you since you talked about Wonder Woman. thank you, JP, for being here. I appreciate it. It's good seeing you. Whoops. I hit the wrong thing. There you go. It's good seeing you again. Who's next, Steve?
It was a car crash.
Yeah.
Shady Petoskey is an Emmy Award-winning TV showrunner developing a bunch of funny, queer, and neurodivergent shows.
Shady Petoskey, welcome to the show. Good. I was a fan of your show on Amazon, Danger and Eggs. I really enjoyed it. What are you working on now?
It's all in development.
But do you have more animated projects coming up? Because I really like that show.
I'm not doing any. Oh, that's cool. Well, I got out of that biz. I'm not doing animation anymore.
Oh, okay.
I have a show that I'm working with Lulu Wachowski. We're doing like a genre show, and then I'm doing a HBO show and just lots of pilots and stuff like that.
Okay, so you're out of the animation biz. So when I said it got any more cartoons coming up, the answer is no.
No. This is so disappointing.
Yes, I know. I'm sad. But what can you tell us legally? What can you tell us about that is coming up?
Oh, no. I've just been sad for a year.
Oh, I got you. Yeah.
I didn't know we were doing this. Look at my Wikipedia. Did they change my Wikipedia back to me being a lady yet? That's all I want to know.
Does that switch back and forth?
I just want to be...
Do you have to check it to
just? I gotta fight 4chan constantly.
I heard
I have nothing going on.
Well, I heard there was this guy on Wikipedia who, like, he was a professor or something, and because he did something notable, he had his own entry on Wikipedia. But because he was he was a professor, he contacted them and said, "Please don't put me. I'm an educator. I'm not part of your bullshit. Take me off your set." But then they were like, "Well, now we have to keep you on because you're the only person who's ever contacted us and told us to take them off of Wikipedia. So you're definitely famous now." It's like a fucking... I have a feeling like when you get sucked into Wikipedia, they kind of they pull you in and you can never get out. That's why
Scientology.
Just like Scientology. That's right. That's why I don't give them money. They took enough of my dignity. Shady, if people want to be a fan, if people want to check out, can you still see Amazon?
Oh, you know what I'm doing? I joined TikTok a couple weeks ago because I got hit by a car on my bicycle.
Man, he's okay.
And yeah.
How?
And so I've been posting depression videos on TikTok.
I've seen a few. So you're saying when you got hit, that was... that spurred you to join TikTok.
That was my
sprawled creative, out in the road. Your first thought was, Phoenix. "I got to join TikTok.
I got to get on TikTok. It's the one thing I haven't done.
It is a bucket list item for sure. I can imagine that. All right. So when can people see that? What is the deal? Where do they look for you on the TikTok?
Shady Petoskey on TikTok.
All right, and some good depression videos.
Sorry.
I love sad injured showrunners. They're my favorite.
Don't we all? All right. Thank you, Shady, for being here. I appreciate it.
Yeah. Thank you for digging into my past.
Hey, everybody who's on Wikipedia, I got to read up. All right. Who's next, Steve?
Shelby Gonzalez is a website designer and comedian who cashed in her 401k to see Devo in concert.
That's right. You're a big Devo fan. We mentioned how I was in a Devo video back in the day. Don't shoot, I'm a man. If you Google "Don't Shoot, I'm a Man" by Devo on YouTube, you can see me in that video. It's very obvious I'm in it.
I made a Devo video.
Yeah?
Really?
Which one?
Well, Yo Gabba Gabba. I worked on Yo Gabba Gabba.
Oh, that's right. There you go.
There's segments, and one of them was a Devo video that we...
Excellent. Did. So, oh, okay. Shelby, cool. You are not the typical Devo fan because you're such a young woman. What is it that, because I get it, though, because my daughter, who is a little younger than you, also, I gave her a bunch of my albums when she was younger, and she really liked listening to the Devo stuff. She was a big fan. What is it, do you think, about Devo that spans generations like that?
You know, I think because a lot of modern music, or what everybody's really into right now, kind of is influenced by Devo, or influenced by someone who was influenced by Devo.
Yeah.
So I just, they're pioneers, and they're super unique, and they're, you know, punk rock, and that they did their own thing, and I've just always really been into that.
And what do you say to people who call Devo one-hit wonders?
Boo.
No.
Besides boo.
Doesn't make any sense.
No. Actions speak louder than words.
True. I've seen many lists of one-hit wonders, and they think because, I guess, Whip It is the only song that charted, people think they're a one-hit wonder, but that could not be farther from the truth. How many times have you seen them?
Them?
Yes, that was a Devo song, Matt.
They were
yeah.
visual artists first, though, right? Like Talking Heads, didn't they start as like visual artists and then go, we want to start a band?
I wouldn't be surprised.
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah.
Mark Mothersbaugh and those guys.
Those bands have a concept.
Yeah.
And they've changed it. How many times have you seen them in concert, Shelby?
Three times. The most recent one was at the Desert Days Festival in 2019, I believe.
A whole festival of Devo.
And then they're gonna be playing at Punk Rock Bowling in November, I think, in Vegas.
End of September.
Yeah, Steve's
end of September.
Steve's all ready to go see that. Are you gonna go see him?
Yeah, for sure.
Excellent. I might actually do that too. I'm so bored. When you're not listening to Devo, you design websites, right?
I do. I make the hell out of some websites.
And if people are interested in seeing some of your work, where should they go to look at it?
I bet it's the internet.
The internet.
Is it a website?
No, I'm the only web developer who doesn't have a website.
I'll send you my catalog.
I'm just going to go to a room and look at it on a computer.
I just do cold faxes. I just fax out.
Good stuff. Why not? No one else is using it.
But no, I'm at fredflash.com. My business name is Jumpin' Fred Flash. It's a play on a Rolling Stones song.
Oh, I'm not familiar with the song. Fred Flash is the name of the website to go to. She does good work. If you need a website, definitely talk to Shelby. Okay, thank you for coming back on the show, Shelby. I appreciate you being here. Who's left, Steve? Anyone?
That is it.
Oh, that's everybody. Okay. Well, in that case, let's move on to our next round now that we know who's playing the game. And let's play the match game. All right, everybody knows how to play the match game, right? This is where you get out your whiteboards or your things to write on and your Sharpie, whatever you got to write with. The way it works is I have some questions here with a blank in them. I will read them. You need to write down your best response to fill in that blank. Now, you guys are all trying to match Steve, all right? Steve has not heard these questions. So I'm going to read them. I'm going to go to Steve for his answer, and then I'll go to the rest of you guys. Everyone who matches Steve gets 1 point. All right, I will also give a point to the most popular answer. If more than one of you says it.
I'm just going to write dog for every question. Do me a solid, all right?
Sure.
But if you happen to match Steve and it's the most popular answer, I'll give you 3 points. So this is a good chance, a good opportunity to score points, especially for those of you who have none. All right, here's the first question. There's a male strip show in Vegas featuring only men over the age of 60. It's called The Thunder from Blank. There's a new male strip show in Vegas featuring only men over the age of 60. It's called The Thunder from Blank. All right, Steve, you ready to go? You got an answer on this one?
I think I misspelled dog.
There's a new male strip show in Vegas, Steve, featuring men over the age of 60. It's called The Thunder from...
My Underwear.
The Thunder from My Underwear. All right, so My Underwear, or something close to that, is what we're looking for. We'll go to JP first. JP, it's called The Thunder from... What did you say?
ARP Under.
The Thunder from ARP Under, sure. AARP. Makes sense, but not a match. Close. Shady, we're looking for The Thunder from My Underwear. What did you say?
I just put hashtag me too.
Okay. Close. That is very close, but not a match. Ron, did you say My Underwear? My shorts. Oh, okay. I think that's a match. Underwear, shorts. I think that's a match.
That's what I meant.
Well done. All right. That's 1 point for Ron. Good job. Matt, did you also say My Underwear or something of that nature?
Pretty close. I had The Grave.
Thunder from the grave. Sounds like a Halloween show. All right, not a match. Shelby, last chance. Did you say something close to my underwear? No, what'd you say?
My butt.
Steve!
That is close to your underwear.
Close to mine, anyways.
Oh. If it's not close to your underwear, you're wearing your underwear wrong.
Or your butt's in the wrong place, one or the other. All right, so that's Ron got 1 point on that one. Good job. Here we go, next question. I was watching this weird episode of Wheel of Fortune the other day. Instead of being hosted by Pat Sajak, it was hosted by Pat Blank. Watch this weird episode of Wheel of Fortune. Instead of being hosted by Pat Sajak, it was hosted by Pat Blank. All right, Steve. I know you're familiar with the Wheel of Fortune show, but this one I was watching was not hosted by Pat Sajak. It was hosted by Pat whom?
Buchanan.
Pat Buchanan, of course.
Because you have to have at least one right-wing nut job on that show at all times.
They said pay $100 to whoever gets a match on this.
All right, so there you go. An extra $100 from Ron if we get it. JP, did you say Pat Buchanan?
It was really weird. It was really confusing because it was hosted by Pat, Itz.
Pat Itz. All right, because yeah, all right, yeah, very good.
Dated. But that's not a very woke joke anymore. No,
not a match, anyways. Shady, did you say what Steve said? Pat Buchanan.
No, I thought he was gonna rhyme again, and so I said Pat Flapjack.
Sure, I like your strategy.
I had so many responses to that.
I like your strategy, Pat Flapjack. That's nice. All right. Oh, God. That is a great stage name. All right, Ron, we're looking for something close to Pat Buchanan. I'm guessing you didn't say that.
It's Pat Sajak, so I thought the new guy's name would be Pat Say Pat.
Pat Say Pat, sure.
which is a tribute to JP's answer.
Pat, say Pat. It's Pat, say Pat. All right. So far, nothing even close to Pat Buchanan. Matt, what did you say?
I got very close to Pat Buchanan. I went with the other political Pat, which is Benatar.
Oh, Pat Benatar, sure. Love is a battlefield, for sure. Not a match. Shelby, what Pat did you say?
I couldn't think of anything.
So what'd you write? Nothing?
I didn't write anything.
All right. Pat Blank. Pat of Butter. Pat Buttram. Nothing. All right. Zero matches in that one. No one said Pat Buchanan. All right. This next one, someone will get a match. Dumb Donald is so dumb.
How dumb is he?
Was it Donald? How dumb is he?
Wow. You guys. Dumb Donald is so dumb.
He's dumb?
Yes, Ron. In fact, he's so dumb that when the coach said he was playing guard, he showed up to practice with a blank. Dumb Donald is so dumb that when the coach said he was playing guard, he showed up to practice with a blank. I took this directly from an episode of Match Game. Word for word. So you should be able
By the way, I've watched entirely all of Match Game 74 and half of 75.
That's almost 2 years.
That's how long it took me.
Just watched one a day. All right. Steve, Dumb Donald is so dumb that when the coach said he was playing guard, he showed up to practice with a...
He showed up for practice with a nightstick.
With a nightstick. All right, because he was a night guard of some sort. All right. I knew it would be a weapon, but a nightstick is what we're looking for. JP, which weapon did you go with?
Taser.
A taser. All right. I like that. We'll probably see that again, I think. Shady, did you say nightstick?
I forgot about weapons. I said Segway.
A Segway. It's Paul Blart. Dumb Donald Blart. It's his brother. All right. Ron, how about you? What'd you say?
Gun.
A gun, sure. That's a weapon. All right, we got all these different weapons.
Am I supposed to write these backwards?
No.
Can we just have a moment to appreciate that really lovely G?
That is a great G.
Show us your G again, Ron. Nice work. Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
Excellent work. Matt?
I'm supposed to write backwards, I guess.
No, we can see it fine.
Oh, okay.
Matt, what'd you say?
Bob, can you just hold it up one more time so I can get a screen grab for the...
Wait, now it's upside down, though. Wait a minute. Okay, Matt, did you say a weapon?
Okay. They still have it. There's some Zodiac killer letters.
I did say weapon, but I've gone with the most obvious weapon that a guard would have, and that is a sword.
A sword! Sure.
I really thought it was going to be Benatar again.
The Benatar.
Love is a weapon. All right, we've got every weapon except Nightstick. Shelby, did you come up with something this time?
It's a badge.
A badge.
That's good.
He just wanted to be official. Good. He didn't care about getting the job done. He just wanted to make it official. I got a badge here. That's all I need.
Yeah.
He showed up in the car and he said, "This badge says I belong here." All right. No matches. Not even a match of each other. Gosh, so far only 1 point scored in this round. Here we go. This one will definitely.
I was going to write Gub. Would you have gotten that?
Yes. Woody Allen, take the money and run. Very funny. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Here we go. Next one. I was thinking of going on a vegetarian safari. I understand that you can come home with a stuffed blank. Thinking about going on a vegetarian safari. I understand that you can come home with a stuffed blank. All right, this one's got a few answers I think we could go with. Steve, I'm going to go on this new vegetarian safari because I understand that you can come home with a stuffed what?
Cantaloupe.
A stuffed cantaloupe. All right. What do you stuff your cantaloupe with, Steve?
I don't know. It's like an antelope, but it's vegetarian. You go on safari to see antelopes. You go on a vegetarian safari to see cantaloupes.
It rhymes.
Well, you know, the contestants, you all get bad answers.
Let's see who said.
Show. I'm on the show.
I'm guessing nobody said cantaloupe. JP, what did you say? You can come home with a stuffed what?
Desperately trying to get a point.
Stuffed pepper, yes. Stuffed pepper, like our moms used to make. I knew someone was going to say it, but not a match. Shady, did you say cantaloupe?
No, of course I didn't.
Of course not.
I don't think there's reason to be disappointed.
I could only think of one vegetable. I just said a stuffed lettuce.
A stuffed lettuce. I don't know.
That's one.
I don't know how that works, but okay. Stuffed lettuce. No. Ron, looking for cantaloupe.
Or pepper.
Yeah. Or pepper, there you go. Pepper. All right. So there you go. Two people said pepper. So there's a point for JP and a point for Ron. Matt, if you said pepper or cantaloupe, you get a point.
Wow.
I think I misunderstood, and I said Benatar.
A stuffed Benatar.
He's joking.
But then I had a second thought, and I went for the... I went for the turkey of the ground, which, as we all know, is the pepper.
The pepper! There we go. Definitely the most popular answer. All right, there's another point for Matt. And Shelby, your last. What did you stuff?
Bell pepper.
A bell pepper! Definitely the most popular answer. All right, so Shelby, Ron, Matt, and JP all got a point on that one with their stuffed pepper. Good job. All right, last question in this round. Here we go. Somebody gave me a talking parrot as a gift. Unfortunately, it sounds just like blank. Somebody gave me a talking parrot as a gift. Unfortunately, it sounds just like blank. Let's see. We got all kinds of people in here. All right. Wilderbeat. All right, Steve. Last one, someone gave me a talking parrot as a gift. Unfortunately, it sounds just like...
Oops. Last minute change. Just assume that I wrote Gilbert Gottfried on here.
So you're changing your answer to Gilbert Gottfried, regardless of what you wrote. Like the parrot in Aladdin.
I thought it was going
to
be Benatar.
Not Gilbert Benatar. All right. So there it is. Gilbert Gottfried. It sounds like Iago. There it is. So JP, we're looking for Gilbert Gottfried. Is that what you said?
I went with the female Gilbert
costume. Oh, Fran Drescher, sure.
Fran Drescher's, that's good.
That is a good answer.
That's good.
Yeah. Shady, did you say Gilbert Gottfried?
I played strategically and I got Gilbert G. I didn't know how to spell God.
All right, Gilbert G.
But that's what I meant to say.
That's a match. I'll take it. Good job. All right, that's a point for Shady. Ron, what annoying person did you say? Trump? Okay. That would be great, though, if you had a parrot. Now it would be good to have a parrot that talks like Trump.
He'd just be like, I'd like to think that my parent has a better vocabulary than that.
Huge. Huge. All right.
Oh, parrots repeat things.
Matt, Matt, did you say Gilbert Gottfried?
It depends how you see me as a person, because I said me.
Well, no. you're close. You are the English Gilbert Gottfried, no doubt about that, but not a match, unfortunately. Shelby, what annoying person did you write down?
Gilbert, I think I spelled his name wrong too. But
Gilbert Gottfried. All right.
Wow.
So not only is that a match, it's now the most popular answer. So that's 3 points for Shelby and 3 points for Shady. Good job. I knew someone was going to score some points in this round. All right, that is the end of the match game round. Everybody, I think, is on the board. Steve, why don't you show us what the standings are? What are the scores right now?
We have Shady in the lead with 6, followed by Shelby with 4, Ron with 3, Matt with 2, and JP with 1.
Ah, here you go. So everybody's on the board. Shady Potosky in first place, running away with it. Who would have thought? Let's move on to our next round. It is our hashtag wars round. Everybody's favorite round is the hashtag wars. What I did is I gave all our comedians a hashtag and told them to come up with as many funny responses as they could. We'll just go ahead and go through them. If it's funny, you get a point. If it's not, no points. The hashtag we went with was change a letter, ruin a holiday. Change a letter, ruin a holiday is what we went with. Examples would be Ass Wednesday instead of Ash Wednesday, Ass Wednesday, or Shove Tuesday. They're both right after each other. Ass Wednesday and Shove Tuesday would be the two examples. All right, so I think everybody gets it. JP, you want to start us off? Give us something good. What do you got?
Sure. Esther.
Esther, very nice. I like it. All right, Shady?
I went with a Chinese Jew year.
Oh, it's very confusing, I would think.
That's
two of them at once, I guess, if you're in a hurry. All right, Ron, what do you got?
Erection Day.
There it is. I knew somebody would do it. Excellent work. Matt
Kirsch. Yeah, but that's not ruining the holiday.
Not for me.
Oh, I guess you're right. I just wanted to, you know how hard it is to change?
Okay. He made it better.
If you have dysfunction and everyone else has erections, it can be really depressing.
True.
It could be trouble.
Or call your doctor.
Any day a year that you can get one.
Call your doctor.
The Democrats have stolen this erection.
Matt, can you top that? What do you got?
Christ gas.
Christ gas. Nice. Because he had too much broccoli. Shelby?
Corpus Christi Day?
As opposed to Corpus Christi Day, which is a very little known holiday. Okay. JP, you got another one?
Hanukkah KKK.
Whoa!
H.
All right. Yeah. Again, another confusing holiday for sure. Shady, what do you got?
I'm allowed to say this. We can remove a letter too, right?
Yeah, just as long as it changed.
All right, Fag Day.
Right, as opposed
to... I'm allowed.
Yeah, Flag Day. Very good. Well done. Ah, nice. I'm glad you said it. Ron Lynch, what do you got?
St. Hattrick's Day.
Hey! Yes. And what do we celebrate on that day, Steve?
Hockey.
We celebrate all the people who have scored
certain hockey plays.
Yes, I like
St. Hattrick is the patron saint of Canada.
It's big in Canada.
I don't think it would affect the drinking at all. That's
no, not at all.
Matt, you got one for us?
Christmas beef.
Christmas beef. Again, a Canadian holiday. Very good. Shelby?
New Year's Day.
Oh, like if you just got surgery and you're back from the hospital. Check it out, everyone. I like it. Ricky in
the chat.
Ricky in the chat said Doxing Day. I like that one. Doxing Day. I'm down.
What is Ricky's address?
Right? All right. Let's go ahead and empty it out. JP, just machine gun them. Read all of them down the list. What do you got?
Mardi Gross. Gabor Day. Secretary's Dad. Cinco de Mano. Five hands.
Sure.
Martin Luther King Senior Day.
Oh, that guy was great. He's overshadowed for sure.
That's it.
Oh, that's good. Good stuff. Ah, I like that. Excellent. All right. Shady, you want to tell us what you got left?
Oh, I just put Ramadad because I don't like my dad.
<You're> Ramadad. All right. Ramadad. Like Ramadad with your car when you see him out on the street. All right.
That works.
Nice. Okay, Ron, what do you got?
Plaque. History Month. Black.
Yes.
Black.
Sure. And you can say that.
You don't know what I'm right.
You can say that.
I'm Indigenous People's Day. I'm digging this. I'm digging this People's Day.
Sure, sure.
Lincoln's Bath Day. Bomb Sunday. You're gonna get worse.
Bomb Sunday.
I wish this one worked, but Labia Day.
You might have changed more than one letter there.
Yeah, a couple, I'm saying.
Yeah.
I said I wish this would work. It doesn't work.
No, right, okay.
You could do laser day, but
you know. The day when you get beach ready.
Yeah. Why man's History Month.
Why man's History Month?
Why man's History Month?
Sure.
It's a reading. It doesn't really work. There's no H if you haven't been paying attention.
But, yeah.
Okay. I'm almost done. Yum. Kipper.
They are good. They are delicious.
They're good. They're good.
And this one I didn't change, but Ramada N.
Instead of Ramadan, Ramada N. I like it.
Ramada N.
N. I like it. Good stuff. Ron,
that's it. I'm done.
Let me ask you, behind you, is that your card?
Oh, that is my card. Wow. How did you do that? That's amazing.
Thank you very much, everybody.
Yeah.
I'm glad you enjoyed it.
That was a good one.
Ricky J's got nothing on this guy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Cinco de Mano, motherfuckers. All right.
He's good.
Matt, knock us out with what you got.
All right. Waste a Sunday. Josh Hashanah. That's just for agent's assistants.
Josh. God damn it, Josh.
President's Dry. That could happen at any moment. Groundhog Day.
Ah, shit.
National Day of Player.
Hey, don't hate the player. Hate the game, right?
Bathers Day. And of course, Super Bowel Sunday.
Yeah, Super Bowel. Excellent. Otherwise known as
Bathers Day is great.
Excellent stuff.
How could I not have thought of that? I mean, you look at Father's Day, and that's
right.
Ground hose at.
I like where all my ground hose. I prefer them up in the air. All right, Shelby, you're last. What do you got for us?
I have Harvey Milf Day. Slack Friday. Just wear slacks that day.
Yeah. Oh, okay. I thought it was the day where we just don't really work very hard.
I mean, you know, choose your own adventure on that one, I guess.
Okay.
Sax Day instead of Tax Day.
Sax Day, sure.
Criber Monday. National Pissing Children's Day.
Wow.
There's a National Missing Children's Day, sure. I guess.
I like Sax. I like Sax Day. That's that was big at George Michael's house was Sax Day. All right, is that everybody? That's all our hashtags. Some funny ones. Steve, why don't you go ahead and recap the scores and see where we are?
All right, we have Matt in the lead now with 11, followed by Ron with 10, Shelby with 9, and JP and Shaddy tied with 8 each.
All right.
So it's still anyone's game.
It's anyone's game. The tide has turned for sure. But now we're going to get serious. Wait, we're going to play everyone's favorite part of the game. Where is it? Oh, here it is. That's it.
Ladies and gentlemen, name that tune.
Yes, we're going to play Name That Tune. I'm going to go ahead and create a chat room here. So I need all you guys to go ahead and go to buzzin.live, either on your phone or on your computer there. I put it in the chat, but I'm going to give you a code to put in. Click join game and then put in that code that I just put in the chat. All right. And go ahead and go to buzzin.live and put in that code. While they're doing that, it's time for another episode of Where Are They Now? Here it is.
Where are they now?
Actresses Sean Sheps and Deborah Engel both took turns playing the daughter of Blanche Devereaux on the well-loved sitcom about four hilarious gals living out their final years in Miami, Florida. After the sitcom ended, the two went into business together, providing cash loans in exchange for jewelry. Do you know what that business was called, Steve?
I do not.
Golden Girls. It was called Golden Girls. Get it?
Yeah.
Golden Girls. I told Steve I'm going to do one of these until he comes up with something better. All right. So four people so far have joined this. We're waiting. We're waiting on Matt.
I've got a question, yes. Paul. It says put in the game code, which I've done, and then it says your nickname. But is it okay if I just put, like, my name rather than, like, the shark?
Yes. Oh, is that your nickname, the shark? I didn't know.
It's just something people sometimes call me.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Anyway, I didn't know. You can put in the shark if you want. I'd be happy to. Go ahead and test your buzzers.
I'll put it, Matt.
Once you're logged in, go ahead and test your buzzers. I see Shady did it and JP, Shelby, okay. So here's how it works. Now that everybody's logged in and everybody knows how it works. Just like the regular Name That Tune, I'm going to play a song. If you recognize the name of the song, go ahead and buzz in. If you get it right, you get a point. If not, I'll continue to play the song and someone else can buzz in until they get it right. All right? Now, all these first songs are all sung by people from The Office. Every one of them is performed by a cast member from The Office. So once you've buzzed in and gotten the correct song, if you can also tell me which cast member of The Office is singing, I'll give you a bonus point. All right? So the first thing, just remember, all you need to do first is just buzz in when you know the name of the song. All right? Here we go. Buzzers are all ready. Name this tune.
When tragedy befalls you, don't let them bring you down. Love can cure your problems. You're so lucky that I'm around. Let my love open the door. Let my love.
There you go. Shady buzzed in. What is the name of that song, Shady?
Let My Love Open the Door.
There you go. It's Let My Love Open the Door, the Pete Townsend tune. Do you know which member of The Office is singing it?
Open the door. Was that Michael Scott?
That's right. That's Steve Carell from Dan in Real Life.
Okay.
That's okay. You got it right. It's from Dan in real life. Good job. That's 2 points for Shady. Excellent. It's just that easy. All right. Buzzers reset. Name this tune.
That was a good practice round. Her name is calls you and it's Sarah.
Whoa, that's Matt buzzing in first. What's that song, Matt?
That's Purple Rain.
Yes, it is. Can you tell me who's singing it? Someone from The Office.
I have no idea.
I know.
Can we take it?
Yeah, go ahead. Who is it, everybody else?
Craig Robinson.
Craig Robinson.
Of course, it's one of the few black people on The Office. Craig Robinson, good job. All right, that's 1 point for Matt. You got that one. Here we go. Buzzers reset. This one's tough. Name this tune. I think of all the worries people seem to find, and how they're in a hurry to complicate their minds by chasing after money and dreams that can't come true. I'm glad that we are different, we've better things to do. May others plan their future, I'm busy loving you. Oh, that's Shady. She saw it coming. What's the name of that song, Shady?
I don't know the name. Is it called Live for Today?
There you go. Live for Today is the name of that song. Do you know which cast member of The Office is singing it?
I'd go with
what do you think?
I'm going to guess Creed.
That's right, because Creed Bratton was a member of the Grassroots, and that is him singing that song. Good job.
She's
honest. Excellent. That's Creed for sure. All right, 2 points for Shady on that one. She's killing it. Here we go. Buzzers reset. Name this tune. Yes, it's a good day for singing a song, and it's a good day. That's JP Manu. What's that song, JP?
The people that you meet in your neighborhood.
That's not what it's called. Sorry. We're moving along. Yes, it's a good day. How could anything be wrong? Good day from morning till night. Anyone else want to buzz in? That's it. Nobody got it? It's called It's a Good Day. Good Day is the name of that song. Anyone have an idea who that was singing?
Was that Rashida Jones?
No, Kate Flannery. Yeah, the great Flannery. She's got a beautiful voice.
The lampshade thing.
Yeah, she's the. If you've never seen the lampshades, take a look and go fucking see those guys. It's very funny. Yeah, she's got a beautiful voice. All right, no one got that one. Buzzers reset. Here we go. Name this tune. I will. That's Shady Potosky. What's that song?
I Will Remember You.
That's exactly what it is. Do you know who's singing it?
I think that's Don't let your Ed Helms?
Yes, exactly right. It's Ed Helms. I enjoy his new show, Rutherford Falls, on Peacock. I watched the whole season. I enjoyed it quite a bit. All right, that's another 2 points for Shady. Killing it. All right, we're going to move ahead. Now, these next five songs, they're no longer being sung by people from The Office, so don't worry about that. But what they are mashups. Yeah. They're two songs mashed up together, all right? So when you buzz in, make sure you tell me both songs that are mashed up,
Do you get it wrong if you only say one?
Yeah, you need to tell me both songs, otherwise get no credit. All right, here we go. Name... Yeah, Matt.
What if you feel that mashups are an offense against God and science is overstepped?
I'm going to change your mind because these are some of the funkiest ass mashups you've ever heard. In fact, let's check out this first one. Name these tunes. That's Matt Kirshen. What are those songs, Matt?
Okay. One of them is I'm Still Standing.
And the other one?
And shitting hell.
I need an answer.
Oh, is it called Missing You?
It is not called that. Shady, you buzzed in second. Oh, God. What are those songs?
Thank You and I'm Still Standing?
That is not Thank You. It's not called Thank You. No, I'm sorry.
Hey, Martin.
Anyone else want to buzz in? Oh. Oh, nobody got it. That is Dido singing, but that's Stan by Eminem.
But it had to actually go to any of the Eminem bits.
What do you want? If the name of the song is Stan, what do you want me to do?
Sneaky.
Yeah,
But he sampled that from Dido's song.
Which is called what?
For playing Stan the Android in the Disney show.
No, it's S-T-A-N. It's S-T-A-N the Android, all right? Let's get it right. What did that stand for, JP?
I got to challenge the judges here.
Okay, go ahead.
Dido's song is called Thank You.
Right.
And Eminem sampled that into Stan.
Okay, hold on a minute. I just want to signify you brought the show to a screeching halt. I wanted to make sure to put that in. So you're saying that he sampled that Dido song. She didn't record it for the song Stan. Because it's my understanding that she re-recorded that for that particular version. It's my understanding he didn't sample it. She actually recorded it.
Well, okay, but the song. No.
All right.
Fair enough. If he had her sing the song,
I think he did.
Called Thank You.
Well.
But it doesn't.
I say it's a three-song mashup.
What's the third one?
Okay. The song is Thank You.
Yeah.
And maybe he didn't sample it, but that is the song. And then she sang it for him over again, but it's the exact same song.
Yeah, if the Eminem part was in there, it'd say, yeah, it's Stan, but I was shady on this.
Although I will say, counterpoint.
Yes, Matt?
I think there's the rain sound at the beginning of the mashup that I should have paid attention to, because that's only in the Stan version and not in the Thank You version.
Oh, gosh.
There you go. Thank you.
I'm gonna blow this whole thing up.
How did nobody have Mather's Day in the hashtag wars?
Well, in the words of Dido, thank you, Matt, for clearing that up for us. All right.
Answer your question.
That's right, Shaddy. I'm taking us both down.
Okay. So now that we've gotten that cleared up,
back
to the game. Ron, if your dog is barking, you got to put it on camera. That's the rule.
He won't come on. He doesn't like the camera.
Oh, he's camera shy. All right. Buzzers reset. Now that we've gotten that out of the way, there shouldn't be any more controversy, especially on this one. Ready? Name
just anger and bitterness.
This tune.
I feel really bad now.
There you go, Shady Petoskey. What are those songs?
Milkshake and Ghostbusters.
There you go.
They're very fast.
Now, if that doesn't make you love mashups, I don't know what will. All right, that's a point for Shady Petoskey. That is Milkshake by the Kellises and, of course, Ghostbusters by Ray and the Parkers. All right, buzzers reset. Next song up, name these tunes.
All you got is this moment. 21st century's yesterday.
That is JP Manu. That's right in your wheelhouse. What are those songs, JP?
Should I Stay or Should I Go?
And
In Excess doing I Need You Tonight.
That's it. There you go. That is I Need You Tonight by Michael Hutchins and the In Excesses. And of course, Should I Stay or Should I Go by Clash. Very good.
That one.
Good job. All right, that's a point for
JP. This makes total sense to me after I find out what it is.
All right, next song, buzzers reset. Name these tunes. Nobody? No one's going to buzz in? That's, of course. Okay, JP, what do you think?
It's All Star.
And
that song where the guy sings one version of the story and then the girl sings her version of the story. And it's
which is called?
know.
Oh, how's this work again in the chat? Got it. It's Shape of You by Ed Sheeran.
Oh.
Shape
I,
was, of,
totally I had that, man.
Shape totally. Of You by Ed Sheeran, and of course, All Star.
What's the song I was thinking of?
By the Smash Mouths. I have
Matt,
no...
Matt,
using, of somebody
Martin,
that
Matt
I used
is
to
using
know,
his
like,
phone.
GoTA.
That's exactly right.
Matt, are you... Well, you can use your phone to buzz in if you want. I'm using my phone.
No, but he's using the thing that tells you what song it is.
I don't think he's doing that. If that were the case, it would take so long to buzz in. It wouldn't be... It would defeat the purpose.
Yeah, you're right. I guess so. What if he has really fast internet?
Well, he's
really
still bleeding.
Got
all right, fast. One more left. Last chance to score points in this round. Buzzers reset. Name these tunes. Wait, Ron, did you just buzz in?
No.
Okay,
you did.
All right. Now this is a story all about how my life got... That's Shady Petoskey. What are those songs?
All right. Just to cover all the bases.
Sure.
It's Gangster's Paradise.
Okay.
Or Amish Paradise.
Uh-huh.
And then the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air theme song.
There you go. You got it. Gangster's Paradise by the Coolios. And of course,
my favorite one.
Fresh Prince. Yeah, man. How do you not love that? All right. That is the end of the Name That Tune round. Wow. Steve,
thank
let's
God.
Recap the scores and tell us where everybody is before we go into the final round.
All right, Shoddy takes the lead with 16 points,
woo!
Okay,
followed by Matt with 12, Ron with 10, and JP and Shelby with 9 apiece.
All right, so that is the standings as we go into the final round of the show, which is, we're calling it, Who Wants to Beat a Geek? There's the music. This is how it works. Before the show, I asked everybody to name a field of study or a field of pop culture that they felt they were an expert in, and Steve and I came up with questions in each of those fields. So one by one, depending on how they finish in the standings, we'll go around, and whoever is left standing in the winner's circle will be our winner tonight. Now, Shady, because you're in first place, you get the first pick, all right? In fifth place is Shelby Gonzalez. She said she was an expert in Seinfeld. So Shady, it's up to you. Would you like to answer this question about Seinfeld, or do you want Shelby to prove that she's an expert by answering the question? Keep in mind, if she gets it right, she will take over in the winner's circle. If you get it right, she's eliminated. Or if she gets it wrong, she's eliminated as well. But you get to choose, Shady. What do you think?
I'm not straight enough to take that. I got to give it to her.
Okay. So as I've said many times, I'm not straight enough, but I've got to give it to you. So Shelby, this is your question about Seinfeld, all right? If you get it right, you move on. If not, you're eliminated for good. You ready? Here's your question.
Okay.
All right, Shelby. Aside from the four main characters on Seinfeld, what other character appears in the most episodes? Aside from the four main characters, Jerry, Elaine, Kramer, and George, what other Seinfeld character appears in the most episodes?
One of the waitresses at the coffee shop.
You say it's a waitress?
I don't know her name.
At Monk's. Do you want to make up a name, or you just want to go with a Monk's waitress?
I can't recall her name, but it's one of the waitresses at the coffee shop.
So you say it's one of the waitresses at Monk's? Is that your final answer?
Yes.
The correct answer is... Hello, Newman! Wayne Knight as Newman appears in the most episodes after those guys. But that was a good try, Shelby. I'm sorry you've been eliminated. Give her a hand, everybody. Shelby Gonzalez. That was a good call, Shady. So you're still in the driver's seat. Next up was JP. Now, JP said he was an expert in the music of Stan Ridgway. So it's up to you, Shady. Do you want to answer this question, or do you want to kick it to JP and see if he can prove that he is an expert in the music of Stan Ridgway?
Oh, and by the... Oh, sorry. Oh. JP, I just wanted to thank you for adding that category because I saw that right before Bandcamp Day. I'm like, oh, that's what I should pick up.
Absolutely. So what do you think, Shady? Is you or JP on this one?
JP's got to answer that.
Yeah, I saw that one coming. All right, JP. So here it is. If you get it right, you take the winner's circle. If not, Shady moves on one more spot. Here's your question about the music of Stan Ridgway. JP, on his 2005 album, Snakebite, Blacktop Ballads and Fugitive Songs, Stan included a song that told the history of his most famous band. What is the name of that song? I'll repeat it. On his 2005 album, Snakebite, Blacktop Ballads and Fugitive Songs.
I'm with you. No, I got you.
Okay.
It's either the, I got to decide between the Ballad of or the Tribute to. I'm gonna say the Ballad of Wall of Voodoo.
You say the answer is the Ballad of Wall of Voodoo. Is that your final answer?
Just in case it's the last chance I have to say anything, it stands for Sentient Tactical Assisting Neo.
Excellent.
And I'm going to go with the Ballad of Wall of Voodoo.
Okay, you say it's the Ballad of Wall of Voodoo. Is that your final answer?
That's my final answer.
He says it's the Ballad of Wall of Voodoo. The answer is Talking Wall of Voodoo Blues number one. So close. It was about Wall of Voodoo, but it was the Talking Wall of Voodoo Blues number one. All right. So, JP, very shrewd, Shady. You did it right. JP has been eliminated as well as illuminated. You're knocking them all down one by one. All right. Next up in the third place spot was Ron Lynch, who said he was an expert in the original Justice League of America comic. So what do you think, Shady? You want Ron to answer that question about the Justice League comic, or do you want to answer it?
Oh, which way is this one going to go?
If I get it wrong, I'm out.
Well, because you're in first place, you get a chance to come back at the very end. So if you get it wrong, you're not eliminated, but Ron does take over in the winner's circle.
Go for it.
I'll take it.
You want to go ahead and answer it? All right. Yeah. Bold move. Okay, so if you get it right, you move on. If not, Ron takes over in the winner's circle without doing any work at all. Here's your question about the original Justice League of America comic. Shady, during one of the annual Justice League and Justice Society crossovers, which character was responsible for the death of Mr. Terrific? During one of the annual Justice League of America and Justice Society of America crossovers, which character was responsible for the death of Mr. Terrific?
I'll just say Superman.
You're going to say Superman killed Mr. Terrific. Is that your final answer?
Yeah.
She says it was Superman. The correct answer is Spirit King. It was Spirit King. Did you know that one, Ron?
I did not.
Oh, okay. So Ron lucked out on that one. All right. But like I said,
Spirit
Shady,
King.
Because you're in first place, you get a chance when it's all said and done. You get a second chance. So just sit tight. Ron is now in the winner's circle. He only has to defeat two more. Matt was in second place. He said he was an expert in physics. So Ron, it's up to you now. Do you want to answer this question about physics, or would you like Matt to answer it?
I'll take it.
All right. Once again, a challenge. So if Ron gets this right, Matt's been eliminated for good. If not, he takes the winner's circle without doing any work whatsoever. Here's your question, Ron.
Your answer is the Dolby effect. Sorry.
It's very simple, Ron. What does a manometer measure? What does a manometer measure? Spelled M-A-N-O-M-E-T-E-R. I suppose it could also be pronounced manometer. How do you pronounce it, Matt?
I would pronounce it the first way.
How do you say it?
Manometer.
Do 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 do. I just want to make sure someone said that. Ron, what do you think? What does a manometer measure?
The size of a man.
A manometer measures the size of a man. All right, is that your final answer?
No.
Okay. What is that?
Yeah.
So you say it's the size of a man is your final answer?
I don't know, and I can't. Yeah, I can't.
No, that's fine. The correct. Do you know the answer, Matt? Because that's clearly wrong. Do you have any idea, Matt?
My guess would be pressure, but I think that's wrong.
Close. It's the pressure of a closed system. Man. Very good. Yes, it measures the pressure of a closed system. So very good. Do you still host that?
That's what I said.
You still host that science podcast, Matt?
Well, I do. Yep.
There you go. He's an expert. All right. So Matt, you didn't even have to work at it. You're now in the driver's seat, but you have to go against our champion. She's back in it. Shady said she was an expert in Jared Leto playing trans women in films. So it's up to you, Matt. If you can answer this question, you can choose to answer this question about Jared Leto playing trans women in films, or you can kick it to Shady. But as I said, if Shady gets it right, she's the big winner. If not, you are our winner tonight. So you have the choice. What do you want to do, Matt?
I think I'm just going to have to risk her not knowing it I'm going to have to pass this one.
All right.
I would not stand a chance.
So he's not a fan of Jared Leto. Nah, not that anyone is, but not familiar with Jared Leto playing trans women. So Shady, this is the moment of truth. It's come back around. If you are, in fact, an expert in Jared Leto playing trans women, you'll be
the
winner tonight. Here is your question. Shady, Jared Leto mentioned numerous times that he waxed his entire body for his performance as Rayon in Dallas Buyers Club. But what part of his body was he particularly worried about growing back? I'll repeat it. Jared Leto mentioned numerous times that he waxed his entire body for his performance as Rayon in Dallas Buyers Club. But what part of his body was he particularly worried about growing back?
I mean, it was part of his Golden Globe speech, right?
I think so, yeah.
You know, when I was playing Stan the Android, I was also worried about a certain amount of hair growing back. I used to have to shave everything except a certain part of my body.
Well, except your head,
He talked about waxing his legs a lot, but I'm going to go with chest.
You're going to say he was concerned with his chest hair growing back.
Yeah.
Is that your final answer?
Yes.
You say he was mostly concerned with his chest hair. The answer is, in fact, his eyebrows. He was most concerned with his eyebrows growing back because he had to shave them twice, which means, Matt Kirshen, you did it right. You are the champion. Give it up for Matt Kirshen, everybody. He is the champion tonight.
Did nothing to achieve it.
He did very little, and yet he came in first. That's how fickle this game show business is. Ladies and gentlemen, that is the end of the show. I want to thank you all for tuning in. Go ahead and sing a good night song with me, everybody. Come on, join in. Well, all right. Okay.
All right.
You win.
Okay.
You are the champion. Well, all right. Okay. You win. But can you do it again? You won the game tonight. And everybody's feeling right. Good night, everybody. On behalf of JP Manu, Shady Petoskey, Rod Lynch, Matt Kirshen, Shelby Gonzalez, and myself, please get the vaccination, wash your hands, stay inside, and remember, Republicans kill cops and rape children. Good night, everybody. Thanks for watching. All right, that's enough.
And then we're free to go.
Hold on.
Bye, JP.
There we
bye,
are.
Matt.
Okay, yeah.
Living legend.
Bye, Shelby. Bye, Steve.
All right, we're off now. Thank you guys so much for doing it. I appreciate it.
Thank you very much.
I appreciate you guys doing it. I'm going to put this on YouTube, and I'll send you a link, all right? Thanks, guys.
All right. Bye. Thanks a lot, guys. Have a good night.
Hey, I'll call you about the thing.